transportation units. SAP defines the transportation unit as the smallest loadable unit in the warehouse process. The most common usage for transportation units is to create a physical copy of the truck. You can use transportation units in the goods receipt process, like a truck delivering goods to the warehouse. And you can use it in the outbound process, like when a truck picks up the goods and delivers them to the different customers. In order to understand how such a transportation unit works, let us check out a small example. For instance, let us assume the International Parcel Service picks up the goods from our warehouse at 5 PM. So you would perform your picking and packing process during the day and store the finished handling units in the goods issue zone, waiting for them to get picked up by the parcel service. When it's finally 5 PM, you can see what kind of physical truck arrives at your warehouse, and you can now start the transportation unit process. You can now create the transportation unit and assign all the outbound delivery orders waiting in the goods issue zone to get shipped by the International Parcel Service. Now, let us have a look at the transportation unit objects. We have a header level, the transportation unit itself, and we have a lot of items assigned to it, the outbound delivery orders. We can now start the loading process. And here, the beauty of transportation units comes into play. They offer you a seamless overview over what handling units got loaded into which truck. They offer the possibility to do a mass goods issue posting for all the handling units being loaded into a truck. They further provide the possibility to print out notifications for other loaded handling units. And they also create the possibility to not only send the outbound delivery information to the ERP system, but also the transportation information by sending an IDOC to the ERP system and automatically creating an SD transport. So to sum it up, transportation units are a simple tool to create more transparency during the outbound and loading process. And they also offer the possibility to send full transportation information to the ERP system. But wait, what if the parcel service arrives with a truck and a trailer? EWM also provides a solution for that. Because since the goods are physically separated into truck and trailer, it would make sense to create two transportation units for this scenario. One for the truck and one for the trailer. But that would be pretty confusing to control during the outbound and loading process. And now the so-called vehicles come into play. With the vehicle, you only have to start and finish the loading process once, instead of multiple times for the different transportation units. By posting the goods issue, the EWM will perform a goods issue posting for all the loaded handling units into the separate transportation units assigned to the vehicle.